The race for a vaccine is getting closer to the finish line, but Pfizer and Moderna's announcements that their vaccines are showing strong efficacy rates isn't stopping other companies from pushing forward in their trials. Fox 5's Misha DeBono is in the South Bay, where another vaccine began its trial.
They get the first shot on day one, and then they get the second one on day 29.
Participants in AstraZeneca's phase 3 coronavirus vaccine trial lined up in Chula Vista Tuesday morning to receive their first dose.
This has been the most highly impacted area in San Diego County.
Administering the trial is in partnership with UCSD. Aaron Gutierrez is a community outreach specialist for the Antiviral Research Center. He says minorities have not been properly represented.
We want to make it easier for them to have access to these vaccines.
To be considered, candidates must meet certain criteria. Hispanic or over 60, and have underlying conditions like heart disease, high blood pressure, or type 2 diabetes. Jamie Heisles fits that bill.
I think if somebody doesn't step forward and be part of the solution, we're never going to find the answer.
He got his first dose 2 weeks ago and is here to get his blood drawn. So far, he's had no symptoms and no discomfort. He'll get his second shot in 2 weeks.
For this test, they're doing twice as many vaccine as they are placebo. So 2-in-1 chance that I'm getting good stuff.
Participants receive $500 if they complete the 24-month trial, which includes 2 shots, blood work, and Teladoc follow-ups. Like Pfizer and Moderna, AstraZeneca hopes to have FDA emergency use authorization by the end of the year. They're recruiting 30,000 people across the country, 1,600 from the South Bay.
We always hear people say somebody should do something. The way to help that is step up and be that somebody.
So again, they're hoping to recruit 1,600 people out of this community. It's sponsored by the NIH, National Institute of Health, and President Trump's Operation Warp Speed. From Chula Vista, Misha DeBono, Fox 5 News.